Today I'll be remaking one of my favorite childhood games, Mario Kart, using my custom C++ engine, in one day. Well, sort of. Now you might be wondering why. Why would I dedicate an entire day of my life to do this? Well, this is how the story went.
Yo, did you start working on your exam?
Okay, pause. This is Silviu. We are at the same game dev university, master, and you might remember from these two videos that I have a game dev curse. Well, I have an exam at that curse, and I have an entire day to finish it. Oh, did he already give us the subject? Pause again. So I actually have only one night to make a game, rather than an entire day, because I am stupid. There are a few possible subjects out of which I'll get one at random, like a fighting game, a platformer, an infinite runner, a shooter, but out of all, I was the most afraid of the subject that Silviu had to make a year ago, a race game, because I thought it would be quite difficult to make it in my engine. I got a race game. Of course I got a race game. So after recovering from the shock, I decided to make a Mario Kart game. I wanted to remake it at some point anyway, because I used to play it a lot with my cousin on his Wii. And it wasn't actually hard at all. You'll see. So the first thing to do was to get some 3D models, and they are usually hard to find. But after some searching, I stumbled across the original 3D models from the game, along with cars, models, and even the maps. You can't imagine how excited I was. So, since I'll be using my own C++ engine, I don't have any fancy 3D physics, because I didn't implement them yet. I might do that in the future. Subscribe to not miss that. So, how can I make a 3D race game without physics? Well, I will use a big brain trick that I'll explain in a second. But first, I had to choose a map, and by choose, I mean I picked the map that was the easiest to implement, aka didn't have jumps, and the terrain was flat, because those didn't work with my big brain trick. Except that I actually made them work. So, I could choose this nice Peach Castles map that has this nice big jump. So, what am I talking about? This is the 3D map that we have to race in. I'll place some markers along the track, and I'll use those markers to describe the road. And for the jump, I can simply make the markers actually 3D rather than 2D and just describe some invisible road where the jump would be. So, I downloaded the map, imported it in my engine, and created a level editor to place the markers. The markers will have a rotation and also a tilt to them, to better follow the road's shape. Now, this is a road seen from above. We have these points and the car. Looking at these two points, we can determine if the car is to the left of them or to the right of them, using a simple formula. This will tell us if the car left this segment of road. Similarly, we can check these two points and the car to see if the car left the road. We will just not allow it to do that. Now we know in what segment inside the track we are, and we can just use some linear interpolation to determine the 3D position of the car inside the segment. And this brings us here. I also took some time to edit the map's materials and made the road look shiny. This does make it look wet, but it shows my nice screen space reflections. I talk about them in this video where I remake Minecraft dungeons, if you are curious. And I also had some help from a college that is talented at 3D modeling to help me fix some problems with the terrain. So, shout out to his profile. I then also added coins and made the car bump into the road. And then I had to go to sleep, but I managed to squeeze adding the wheels of the car just before I had to present the game to the teacher. And like, come on, look at it. Doesn't it look great? Of course I got a max score. Now this is great, but I would want to add some enemies.
Bro, you're still here.
Silviu? What are you doing here?
Yeah, you paused the Discord call, don't you remember? I've been waiting here for the whole time.
Oh, sorry. You can go. Anyway, I wanted to also add, you know, some enemies in the game, and the iconic level preview of the level from the original game. I won't add all of the characters because I have to change their pose by hand, so I added Bowser because it is the most iconic, and Boo because this was my favorite character to play back in the day. And here is the final result. Well, you know, it might not be the best clone out there, but I really think it is great after I have spent so little time on it. And plus, it is made in my own C++ OpenGL engine. And I have to say, my game looks better than Silviu's, and his game was made in Unity, so checkmate game engines. So if you would like to see part 2 of this video, where I would make another map, share this video and if it gets to like a billion views, or just a few thousands should be enough, I'll release part 2. And go check out this video about how my engine works. Also, Nintendo, please don't sue me. I'll never claim ownership over your property, I promise.